This is the land of the Kingala.
Ah! Could we please fly lower over it?
Of course we can.
Could we come back for a moment over the river?
Mm-hmm. This is the worst place to reach. I don't think it's ever been explored.
This is where my father's plane crashed. 15 years ago.
Was he a pilot, your father?
No, he was taking part in a scientific expedition. The circumstances were mysterious, but no one had the courage to do any investigating.
It's not a question of courage. Seen from up here, you get a different impression. But this area really is inaccessible.
Still, an explorer went there some time ago. Maybe he could take me through the region. His name is George Barrett. He wrote a book about his journey.
George is an old friend of mine.
Marvelous. Where can I find him?
He's an animal and leaves his hole only at night when he needs a drink.
Welcome to my club. There's a table over there. You'll find it very nice. Yes. Here, nobody will disturb you. I'll bring you something to drink. Rum?
Thank you.
You wanted to see Mr. Barrett, didn't you?
Is he already here?
Yes, but he's in conference. If I want to disturb him, he would become very angry. Have a little patience, eh?
Cards? $100.
No.
$500.
George, there's a visitor, a blonde.
The usual heiress who wants to spend daddy's money, playing the safari bet? I'm not interested.
Call ya.
Chang. Wait a minute. She's pretty?
Yes, yes. Mr. Barrett, miss. I am honored to introduce you. I'm sure he will be very happy to listen to you.
If it weren't for the Chinese, life would be more drab. The usual. George Barrett, 35 years old. A beachcomber of African shores, friend to all and none. Those are my credits.
You're a writer, too.
Things of the past. I don't write anymore. Are you alone?
Yes.
What are you doing here?
I came here to talk about your book. It's quite good.
Well, thanks a lot. You're very sweet. I'll be polite with you. You're about the fourth or fifth person who has read it. Excuse me, what was your name? I didn't get it.
My name is Isabel Donovan.
Donovan. I knew about another Donovan who came to Africa many years ago. He was killed here.
He was my father.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's why I came here. The plane he was flying crashed in Transkangala. Many of the chapters in your book are about that region, so that means that the district holds no mysteries for you. I ask you to help me find the remains of the plane.
Send a message to the chief, understand? The daughter of Donovan has arrived in Nairobi, and she has the intention of reaching Transkangala. She seems the type to get there. Right. Until now, she has spoken only to George Barrett, the drunk. No, nobody. She won't speak to anybody else.
I didn't hear anything, Okiki. You know that. I never hear a thing.
It's easy to dream. Expeditions. Adventure. But in a way, things always assume a false dimension. Here you deal with reality.
What's happening?
Stay here, don't move.
What happened?
A drunk. We better get out. Who gave you that?
My father. When I was a child, he sent it to me from Africa. Barrett! Mr. Barrett, what's wrong with you?
Nothing. Told you I was rotting away. When do you want to go?
Whenever you're ready.
Okay. Where are you staying?
Hotel Continental, room 204. Tomorrow.
See you there tomorrow.
Thank you. I'm coming.
Isabel.
Norman.
Yes, my dear. Are you going to make me wait out here in the hall?
What a surprise. Please come in. Sorry to be in this condition, but I really wasn't expecting you.
What on earth's going on? What do you mean by leaving New York without telling me?
Will you forgive me, Norman? I knew you wouldn't appreciate my decision.
Quite right.
I preferred not telling anyone. Not even you.
After the years of friendship and trust that your father and I always had for one another, Isabel, not to mention my interest in your welfare, I feel you owe me an explanation.
And so you came from New York just for me?
You can interpret my coming here in any way you want. But my main reason was to warn you away from this foolish and dangerous adventure. I know the Transkangala. Your father and I explored the entire region when he and I were partners. I know what it's like, what a hellish place it is. I don't want you to travel through it alone.
I won't permit you to neglect your own interests.
My dear girl, my first interest is to protect your life. I promise that to your father.
Thank you, Norman. Yes? Is that you, George? There will be someone else with me. Fine. Tomorrow at dawn.
It's an honor to have such an important scientist as you on this trip, Mr. Albright.
Thank you. Business doesn't usually permit me to participate in adventures of this kind. Nothing's different. It's like going back 15 years.
Weren't you a partner of Donovan, Isabel's father?
More than that. We were like brothers, he and I.
Were you?
Yes, he was.
That's not true, Norman, and you know it as well as I.
I beg you, Isabel. This sort of thing is important only to us. Let's respect the memory of your father.
Going on?
It is a song of sadness. One of the townspeople is sick.
Or dead.
Guru! Guru! Buena! Guru! Buena!
Guru is a big, big curse.
It's her son. He was beaten and murdered.
Mom!
When they beat and tortured him, he was nearly dead. This is what did it. It contains a kind of poison, a drug which paralyzes.
Are you sure?
There must be something wrong. The only people that know this drug are the Wanderi. They are people from the interior that no one has ever approached. 400 miles from here.
George, the bearers have all gone away, and the boats have been sunk. Come and see.
Wait here. Ingeri, you're a great medicine man. You're going to explain to me who came to Garena last night, and what happened to my bearers.
Evil spirits send curse. Men run away. He stay back. He die.
It was your prophecy. You told the men not to come with me.
Great spirit speak to Ngiri.
Oh, yeah? Is this from your spirit? Who gave it to you? Who gave it to you? Prepare the fire circles.
No, no, Buona, not hurt Ngiri, no.
Then tell me who came here last night.
It was Okeke, the Nigerian.
OKK! OKK! Ingalana! Ingalana! Ungalana! Ungalana!
What are they doing?
It's to test the truth of the prophecy. One of them must die.
Thank you.
Packers keep putting the name.
Guard him well, until I return. Bogo, take care of my friends for tonight. And I want all the men with me to prepare a boat. Tomorrow we leave, at dawn.
Something in common. Thanks. We're both in love with this beautiful country. Isabel's father was exactly the same way. Rest his soul.
He was a scientist, wasn't he?
Yeah. But I always had the feeling that his scientific research was just an excuse to stay down here as much as possible.
When he disappeared, he was convinced he had made an important discovery. I found certain hints of it in his notes. It would have been a very important discovery of some plants that had disappeared for over 1,000 years. Do you want a cup too? It's hot.
There's one thing we've left unfinished. When your father crashed, was he by any chance traveling alone?
Even if Norman doesn't want you to know about it, I want you to know the whole story. When my mother died, my father traveled around the world. He married an Oriental princess and came to Africa. When the plane crashed, she was with him on board, with their 3-year-old daughter.
Isabel, it seems you take pleasure in telling these intimate details about your father.
George! Come and see.
Place to spend the night.
Do you think we're anywhere near where the plane crashed?
I don't know.
More than 2 hours.
We have to get out. Get my guns and the guns of the other men.
I was hoping we'd have time for a cup of tea. I'm tired.
Mbogo, get going.
What's all this about?
It's simple. We're moving.
Impossible. We're all tired.
Those boys who pushed the raft all day are more tired than you are. Look at them hustling now. They don't want to lose their lives. And it's me who's in charge of this expedition, not you. And don't you forget it. Guy gets on my nerves.
Will you excuse Norman? He's used to giving orders.
Will you do me a favor?
Sure, what is it?
Button up your shirt. Use this as the base camp in our search for the airplane. From tomorrow on, we'll explore this area. Then the real difficulties will begin. Good night.
Good night.
Go get some sleep.
It's so wonderful out here. And the sky seems so different from ours.
See the Southern Cross?
Is that the one with the sparkle?
That's Alpha and Centaurus. When I was a child, I often dreamt of getting there.
Do you still dream about it?
Those ancient torches up there occasionally saved my life.
George, when you talk about the stars and Africa, your voice changes and your expression. When my father used to tell me stories about this country, he had the same expression.
Good night, Isabel.
Good night.
not possible. It's crazy. It couldn't be her.
I'd like to know. What direction did that shot come from?
Down there.
Take a couple of men and look for Norman.
She ran away. No one ever saw her close. They think she's a goddess.
If anyone ever discovers her, it'll be the end of both you and me. Do you understand? Get rid of her.
You make it sound easy. The jungle would rebel against us. The Wandera worship her as a goddess.
She must disappear at all costs.
Now, you are going to cross the jungle. My men are ready. It would be much easier to make George Barrett disappear.
Norman, are you all right?
Yes, I heard something outside the tent. I got up. I thought I'd better go and have a look. It turned out to be a gorilla. Fortunately, I had my gun with me. I think I wounded him.
Come and lie down.
Oh, Norman, just leave your gun here with me. You won't need it.
What's the matter, George?
That rifle hasn't been fired in a long time.
Mbogo. Watch the camp. We'll be back at sundown.
Mr. Barrett, where is Isabel?
Yeah. Isabel. Isabel! Where are you, Isabel? Isabel, we're waiting for you. Isabel! Isabel!
Oh. George! Don't come any closer, I lost my clothes! Instead of laughing, why don't you give me your jacket?
Here.
George, what are you doing?
Well, you're not going to wait until Christian Dior comes along,
Let
are you?
Let me go! Let me go!
Stay in the rear.
How did you manage to discover it?
It wasn't hard. I saw it on Norman's geographical map.
Oh.
Niaya. Waritaya. Koyana yabakaba. Ayagala bariya. Bia. Bia.
There's another lake.
The surroundings are full of lakes. And it's not by mere chance that we came out here. Your father's last radio message was that he was left without fuel in this region. His tank had a hole in it.
We know all about the story, Mr. Barrett. Poor old Eric.
It may be that we have to search underwater. I have all the scuba gear with me.
Just Thomas Bat.
About half an hour to get back to the campsite. It's going to get stormy.
Right.
Back to camp. Come on.
They took us by surprise. I tried to hold them back, but I couldn't. They used poison darts on us. They wounded two of them in.
Isabel, take care of the wounded. Cut some branches. We must make stretchers if we want to move them away.
Our lives are in danger. We haven't got time to worry about the wounded.
We have to. To leave them here means letting them all die.
What does it matter if they do? It wouldn't be any loss.
Norman!
I'm warning you. Put that spear down or I'll fire.
Norman! Stop! What are you doing?
Hold on. Let's get to the caves. Go on.
Thank you.
We'd better get going. Come on. Move.
Region of the caves. Stay here. I'm going forward.
How do we know that you're planning to come back?
Bogo! Bogo! You go ahead and give us a signal when you find the caves. Come on.
Keep them awake. Otherwise, they're done for.
Is it possible to save them?
Have you ever heard about a drug that they call endonin? They use it. Native blowguns, they put a lot of it. The Wandari use it. It's a very strong poison that paralyzes the nerve centers, which only the natives have found. As you can see, I've had some experience with it myself.
Like it? Ha 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 ha.
I'll bet you regret you didn't kill me at the right moment.
All a matter of calculation. I needed you alive.
Ah, you are as clever as a jackal. But OKK is more clever than you are. The gun. Let's go. You didn't believe that I was a chief, and now your eyes are full of amazement. Isn't that right?
No, it's not. A chief isn't a worm, content to lick his master's boots.
Repeat what you said, and I'll tear your tongue out.
Dope peddling. It's quite a business, OKK. But you're always out here with the animals in the bush. Your life is worse than that of the animals of the jungle. Come on. Take me where you have to take me.
Who told you about the drug?
You cultivate your plants in an underground cave and organize the transport to Nairobi. But after Nairobi, you're not the boss anymore. After Nairobi, you cash in for a fistful of pounds. And they send you back to the jungle in order to play chief to those men over there. And meanwhile, the narcotics travel. For every mile they travel, there's something in it for your boss.
This white man knows everything, but one thing he will never know, because he is white. This country is Africa, and it belongs to us, the Africans. You will see with your eyes. Get going.
George!
George! George!
Don't be stupid, Isabel. It was a mistake getting mixed up with him.
Why do you hate him so?
The man's too smart for his own good.
What are they going to do?
Just a minute. You shouldn't have gone away and left us alone. You two make mistakes once in a while. Now, I'm going to show you something interesting. Right here. This plant is the source of endonin, a drug which is more in demand every day. These plants are rich in it. You're looking at a treasure, and the supply belongs to me.
They're carnivorous.
Yes, and greedy, too.
The scientific discovery of Isabel's father.
That's right. He confided it to me. We were going to market the drug together before his unfortunate plane crash. My friends, the Wandiri, get the food that the plant needs. It's not always an easy task for them to do, I assure you.
What would Derek Donovan say if he were here.
But he's not. And pretty soon you won't be with us either. Okay, Kate?
Now wait, friend. I'm just going to settle a little question of injustice between us. There's one small item of importance that you forgot to take into consideration. You have always sent orders from New York to Nairobi. But now, I am giving the orders. If you want to leave the jungle alive, give me the names of the people who take the drug. Who are they?
Don't threaten me. You can't do anything alone. The people I deal with wouldn't do business with you.
I can always find whites who are willing to serve me. All I do is pay. Is that right, Mr. Barrett? Where money is concerned, what is the difference between white and black?
The difference between black and white men has nothing to do with it. As far as I'm concerned, there is a difference between an honest man and a cheat.
Luana!
Get these off, will you?
Here, let me help. Are you all right?
Are you coming with us, Norman? I think I found the airplane.
Yes, of course.
Follow me. That he was losing altitude near a lake.
Poor Derek. It came to a tragic end, but it was his idea to sell the drug.
Now, you don't mind throwing dirt on my father's memory.
I share some of the responsibility. It was my fault, too. Ultimately, I became a prisoner to my own greed. It was natural. You would have, too. So KK became a victim of temptation just as I did. But at first, it wasn't a question of money or smuggling. The criminal aspects of it all didn't strike me. Derek said it was above board and calmed my suspicions. You could say he took advantage of my admiration. I had no idea what he was up to till it was too late.
The words of the living against the silence of the dead. We'll find out. Mbogo, watch Mr. Albright while we descend. And keep awake. He's extremely clever.
His diary.
Look at the last pages.
Norman does everything to convince me to exploit my discovery. His mercenary interest in the drug worries me, and his threatening attitude has given rise to a suspicion so frightening that I hesitate to write it down. The last entry reads, "My partner continues to be fascinated with the extraordinary power of the plants as a drug." Norman's words have become menacing, and by now I am convinced that the three accidents I escaped were actual attempts on my life. I must be on my guard. I don't know when the next attempt will come. But when it does, I shall be ready to trap Norman in his own snare.
All right, that's enough. Stay where you are. Unfortunately, your father was not ready for the fourth and last accident, the punctured fuel tank. It was all very easy, almost as easy as this is going to be.
I almost envy her. What are you going to do, George? Go back to Nairobi in the same old life?
I don't know. I've been thinking about it. What are you going to do?
I haven't decided.
Why don't I decide for both of us? You'll stay, won't you?